اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم. أستغفر الله. What can one say in the majlis of Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam? The majlis of Sayyidul Wujud wa wasitatu kulli mawjud sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. We are, alhamdulillah, ba'da a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, humbled every time we are called to say something about Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The tongue, yani, what have been said about him from beginning to end, all the madih and na'at and salawat and whatever you have is nothing that can give an estimation of his qadr. And I'm very honored and happy to be called here to Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, sallu ala al-habib, sallu ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Spiritual Society, Canada. This is a great ni'mah, because as we traveled around the world, and I just came to visit from visiting my Shaykh, Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad Adil, recently. The places where one can find spirituality now are very few. To have spirituality in Islam now is rare. You go many places, but you don't find spirituality. Yes, you find people doing and not doing, but the dhawq, the taste, is hard to find nowadays. And the simple reason for this is that people have forgotten what is the spirituality of Islam. My Shaykh one time, Mawlana Shaykh Nazim Adil Haqqani, before he left this physical realm, one time he had a reporter and he asked him, "Oh Shaykh, what's that?
السلام عليك يا رسول السلام عليك يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك أشرق الكون ابتهاجا بوجود المصطفى أحمد ولآل الكون أنس وسرور قد تجدى يا نبي عليك صلوات الله عليك من رأى وجهك يا سعد يا كريم الوالدين حوضك الصافي المبرد وردنا شوري يا نبي يا حبيب صلوات الله
ألف الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله يا رحمة للعالمين يا شفيع المذنبين. بسم الله تفضل. Islam without spirituality is like a body without a soul. That's the reality. And the soul of this religion is Sayyidina Muhammad. He is Abu al-Arwah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Your relationship to Sayyidina Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, dictates what kind of spiritual life you will have. How much respect you have for him, how much love, how much honoring you do of him, will increase you in spirituality. They came to my Shaykh, Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, قدس الله سره العزيز. His son now, Mawlana Shaykh Muhammad Adil, is his Khalifa, our Shaykh, following on the same path. They came to him and said, "Oh Shaykh," one reported, "what is spirituality in Islam?" He said, "My son, spirituality in Islam is to love holy ones and to dislike unholy ones. That is spirituality in Islam." And Imam al-Muttaqeen, Qaid al-Ghurr al-Muhajjaleen, Mawla al-Thaqalain, is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't think the Holy Quran, when he praises only in few verses, وَإِنَّكَ وَاسْتَعِدْ بِاللَّهِ وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ صلى الله عليه. How many verses like this explicitly mentioning Prophet? Limited. The entire Quran is madih of Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. From beginning to end, when Allah talks about al-muttaqeen, inna lil-muttaqeen mafaza.